It's your boy, Sabai from the Sabai Cartel, and I'm back with another Modern Warfare video. Now, I got the Damascus camo in Modern Warfare, finally, and one of the things that took me some time were the rockets. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the best tips and, of course, the mistakes that you're making when it comes down to getting platinum rockets as fast as possible. The first mistake that you're making is you're playing Ground War. Get away from Ground War. Stop. Don't play Ground War. A Ground War game takes 20 minutes. And the craziest thing about Ground War that I noticed as I was going for these platinum rockets is that everybody and their mama is going for platinum rockets in Ground War. Sometimes you see a killstreak in Ground War, you want to destroy it, and by the time your rocket gets there, another person destroys the UAV, the VTOL, the personal radar, or whatever other killstreak it's available in the map. Playing Ground War is the biggest mistake that you can make. I actually got the Pila Gold in just 3 hours, actually, by not playing Ground War. What did I play? Hardcore Shipment. You want to make sure that you're playing the Hardcore Small Map playlist or Hardcore Shipment 24/7. You could do Hardcore Shoot House if you're not a huge fan of Shipment as well, but Hardcore Shipment helped me out big time. People were always summoning personal radars in there, and they were always summoning UAVs, so it was just pretty easy to complete a lot of the challenges for my rockets. Anyways, I also want to point out that the reason why Hardcore Shipment's good is because, like I said, you're going to be seeing a lot of personal radars, which you're going to need because personal radars count as ground vehicles. And the ground vehicle challenges, you know, they're not super time consuming, but they are a bit time consuming, specifically if you get unlucky and specifically if you're like a really good player. I'm not saying this to brag, but one of the biggest, reasons why I took so long with the rocket launchers is because I'm actually pretty decent at the game. And I would always just kill people before they would even have a chance to get a personal radar. So I do want to point out, if you're an average player and you play Hardcore Shipment and you die pretty often, trust me, you're going to be able to do your launchers way faster than I did. Now, the first massive mistake, well, the second, because the first mistake was playing Ground War. The second massive mistake that you're making when it comes down to getting platinum launchers is you're not doing the RPG first. What are you doing? Like, do you like torture? Because the RPG took me 8 hours and 46 minutes to complete. Some of you guys might be like, well, what do you mean? Why did it take you that long? Well, the reason why it took me that long is because it's basically impossible to destroy a UAV with the RPG. In the 8 hours and 46 minutes that I was using the RPG, I was only able to destroy one UAV with the RPG. And every single time that there was a UAV up in the air, I would always try to shoot it down with the RPG over and over and over again. And I was never able to get the UAVs. I watched countless videos on how to destroy UAVs with RPGs, and none of them helped. The thing is, the reason why you want to do the RPG first is because of those annoying Tiger Camo challenges. The Tiger Camo challenges basically have you destroying support streaks. So it pretty much came down to counter UAVs and personal radars for me, because of course UAVs were pretty much out of the question. From my understanding, also the mounted turret is also a support streak, but please don't quote me on that, I'm not that sure. So that's how I got the Tiger Camo for the RPG, and that's why the RPG took me so long. After you do the RPG, then you want to make sure that you do the Strela. Alright, the Strela is pretty easy, and it's actually pretty easy to destroy UAVs with the Strela as well. Just aim a little bit forward, when shooting down a UAV, and you should be good. Sometimes with the Strela, you're not going to be able to destroy UAVs on your first and second try, but it's definitely way easier to destroy UAVs with the Strela than the RPG. Now, some people might say Hardcore Shipment is a terrible idea for platinum launchers because it's always hectic and you're always going to get destroyed. Well, that's where my next tip comes in. If you're going for platinum launchers, always have a smoke grenade with you. You throw the smoke grenade on the ground and then you look straight up and then you can see the UAV that, of course, is going to be up in the air, and you can easily shoot down a UAV without any trouble. I can't tell you guys how many times I threw down a smoke grenade on the ground, and that smoke grenade helped me destroy VTOLs easier, chopper gunners easier, UAVs, etc., etc. Let's talk about the Pila now, right? It's honestly the easiest launcher to get gold, okay? Which is why I did it for second to last. I know a lot of people think the Joker is hard, but the Joker, to me, was like the easiest, so that's why I did it last. But the point is, the best advice that I can give you guys for the Pila is, when you're destroying VTOLs with the Pila, don't use the lock-on feature for the VTOL. Just make sure that you fire it in free fire. The Pila is actually pretty accurate. The reason why I don't recommend that you lock on with the Pila when they're storing a VTOL, because sometimes there's a guy in the lobby with an RPG, for example, that is going to destroy the VTOL. And the reason why he destroyed the VTOL before you is because, of course, you were too busy trying to lock on. So the best tip that I have for the Joker when it comes down to getting it in Platinum is always make sure that you're aiming it towards the spots where you think the bad guys are going to be at. It's just a simple common sense tip, but I still want to point it out anywhere because sometimes common sense is not as common. I also want to make sure that I give you guys some really good Joker spots on shipment. So the gameplay clips that you guys have been seeing in the background is of course some really good Joker spots on shipment and some of the Joker spots that I use to get objective kills, hardpoint kills, etc, etc. Of course, make sure that you can also throw down a smoke bomb when of course aiming towards a specific Joker spot as well. That's gonna help you out big time as well. Of course, the biggest massive tip would also be make sure that you're doing these rocket challenges passively, all right? I did the Pila in about 3 hours, and throughout those 3 hours, I leveled up, I think, 3 weapons, okay? Like I said, I'm a pretty decent player, so I leveled up weapons super, super fast, specifically because there was a double weapon XP weekend as well, okay? But definitely make sure that you're always having a rocket on your back, and you don't constantly switch out rockets either. Just focus on one rocket at a time, and again, focus on the RPG first. Another tip that I can give you guys is if you guys don't really care about your KD, which you shouldn't care about your KD because there's skill-based matchmaking in this game, and the lower your KD, the easier the lobby. So I don't really understand why people want to have a big KD nowadays in Call of Duty. But if a guy killed me 2 times in a row, I would just run at him and I will let him kill me a 3rd time in a row because that would mean that he was going to summon a personal radar or a UAV. That's a little bit of a tip for you guys. Another tip that I have for you guys is if you're trying to destroy a VTOL, have your boy shoot an RPG at the VTOL first, and then of course you finish off the RPG. The munitions box field upgrade is also going to give you 1 rocket into your rocket launcher, okay? Let's say that you use the 2 rockets that the Pila has, you use the munitions box, boom, you're going to have another rocket. And last but not least, the objective bullets are going to be your best friend. When it comes down to all of these other camos, for the rockets, let's talk about them. Let's talk about the Skulls Camel challenges. You have to destroy vehicles with this thing. Just destroy down UAVs, and trust me, you'll get this challenge done in no time. Then, of course, there's the challenge for the rockets that you have to destroy ground-based vehicles. So the VTOL counts as a ground-based vehicle. The counter UAV counts as a ground-based vehicle. The personal radar counts as a ground-based vehicle. The Wilson counts as a ground-based vehicle. And of course, the mounted turret and the sentry gun also counts. Of course, you also have the IAD, the advanced infantry vehicle, something like that, and you also have the other ground vehicles in ground war. But again, we're not playing ground war. Also, if you go into ground war and you just destroy vehicles with your rocket and an enemy has not used the vehicle, that vehicle will not count. Guys, ground war is a waste of time, just take my word for it. Anyways, that's pretty much it when it comes down to getting Platinum Rockets in Modern Warfare as fast and as easy as possible. If you guys follow these tips, you're going to be able to get Platinum Rocket Launchers in at least 3 days. 1 full day to level up all the launchers to max level, and 2 days getting the launchers, the Launcher Camo challenge completed. If you enjoyed the video, drop it a like, subscribe to join the Sabaya Cartel, and I'll have more videos on how to get the Damascus Camo as easy as possible on the channel. So, of course, feel free to check out the Damascus playlist in the description below. Peace.